invite you to join us to the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Will the secretary take, oh, I'm sorry. Well, let me do the fire announcement first. In case of fire, there are two ways to exit the chambers. To my left, you'd exit those chamber doors, turn left, and go down a flight of stairs. Or the best way is perhaps at the back of the rear of the chambers and exit those doors. In either case, once you're outside of the building, please walk a safe distance away from the building. Now, secretary, take the roll.
Charles Durin?
Here.
Elizabeth Ballard?
Here.
Kathleen Sarno?
Here.
Peter Falk? Here. Lori Longy?
Here.
Nicholas Sepakis?
Here.
Charles Ladd?
Here.
Alan Gregory?
Here.
Alan Drinan?
We have, what, seven present and one alternate? Okay. Motion is in order to go into executive session.
So made.
This is just to
second.
Do a discussion of legal problems and anything else you want to add to that. So just an update on the legal situation.
Yeah, all legal.
Okay. The motion's made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. We will go upstairs. I'm sorry. Downstairs at the break room?
Downstairs in the break room.
Okay.
And I have to let you in.
Yeah. Hopefully we'll be back shortly. I'm sorry?
You should put on the record that you've invited.
Back to order. In the executive session, there was no votes taken and no decisions made concerning litigation. Secretary, please take the roll.
Charles Stern.
Here.
Elizabeth Ballard.
Here.
Kathleen Sarno.
Here.
Peter Falk here. Lori Longi.
Here.
Nicholas Sefakis.
Here.
Charles Ladd.
Here.
Ronald Gregory.
Here.
Alan Drynan.
Okay, approval of minutes September 4th. Do you remember back that far?
Yep. I'll make a motion to approve the September 4th, 2014 minutes.
Second.
Motion's made, seconded. Any errors, additions, or omissions?
Yes. I actually have the minutes that were given to us way back when, that there were a lot of errors in them, and I found a lot of the same errors, and so I'm thinking at this point, we should get them corrected.
Errors, omission, or what?
Yes, there were,
September.
Page, like, 11. And there were some of the exact same things that I actually have already highlighted, so it just seemed like they never got...
Well, what are they?
...fixed. Okay. Page... Let's see. I'll start from the beginning. On page 7... on the second line to the bottom, after the board's direction... the next line was Commissioner Longi said it's in 12.20A, and that's in our old notes, and instead of fixing it, they just deleted the line.
I'm sorry, where are you?
On page 7 of 22.
Right.
And what are you reading?
And the second to the last line, after it says the ZEO works under the board's direction.
The second paragraph.
Yeah, the second paragraph. I'm sorry. Second paragraph, second to the last line.
Up in here, right here.
Yeah.
After the board's direction, the next line was Commissioner Longi said it's in 12.20A, and instead of correcting the mistake that was in the line, they just deleted the line.
Well, does that make it much difference?
Well, yeah, because the context of the beginning was about the ZEO.
I don't know. I don't see it.
And then,
it's not in there. That's what you're saying.
It's
omission.
It was in this set of minutes that they first gave us that we went through all the corrections. And so I even have where I wrote it. There was, in the first set of minutes, it said the word 508, and instead of correcting the error in it, they just deleted the whole line.
Well, that's the way they corrected it.
That's the way they corrected it, I guess. I don't know. I think it's the old correction thing.
So, well, what are we
so that,
supposed to be in here?
So we have to add back in that line.
But it's not.
Okay, so she wants directions on where on the page 7 of 22.
Yeah.
On the second paragraph, second line up. At the point where it says the board's direction, insert the following.
Commissioner Longi said it's in 12.20A.
And then that would just go along. She said this is a problem. They went from.
They had the wrong zoning section. And instead of correcting the section, they just deleted the line.
Okay. Well,
that was one thing.
Takes care of it.
On page 11, the second large paragraph under the Karen LaPlante section, the correction was second line to the bottom. It says, would be a different value at bigger lots. The correction was supposed to be on bigger lots. And then
on page 19. On the second paragraph.
There's a runoff.
Blatt and had were still run together.
Yeah.
But two lines down, it was supposed to be might have instead of might.
Might have.
And page 21, under general conditions number 34, we had added in the word site on the second line where it says the nature of the use or the structure, comma, site will require new approvals. So it was missing that second.
That's the word site.
Site.
Okay.
And then page 22, we had made mention at that meeting that the zone was missing out of the, under the SPR 1635, they were omitting the zones from all of our applications, and we added the zone in, but it's not in this, in these minutes.
Yeah, but what's the zone? Where do you put it?
I didn't have the zone. I only had the edits, but it never got edited. I don't know what the zone is for the King Street, 1600 King Street, but the zone, we added it in that night.
Okay.
And the last thing I noticed was, I guess Al had added in a thing about the video of the meeting being available, and that was missing from the first set of minutes to the minutes that were here on this thing. There was a video of this meeting at the Enfield website, and that was in that set of meetings, and it wasn't here.
So you want that comment added again?
Yeah, where would that comment go?
The comment was on this set of minutes, and I can give you this
there. Is it something that needs to be in there?
He had added it in there. It was video of this meeting is available on our Enfield. He wanted the video to be on in our minutes so people are aware that there's a video.
So this would be added towards the end?
Yes. It was after the, just above the line that said respectfully submitted.
Okay.
Anything further, additions, errors, or omissions? Hearing none, all in favor as amended?
We'll do a roll call.
Well, yeah, well, do a roll call, right.
Okay, Charles Duran.
4.
Elizabeth Ballard.
4.
Kathleen Sarno.
4.
Peter Falk. 4. Lori Longhi.
4.
Nicholas Sefakis.
4.
Charles Ladd.
4.
7-4-0 against and no abstentions. At least we have that one cleaned up. September 18th. Regular meeting.
Make a motion to accept the minutes of the September 18th regular meeting.
Second.
Motion's made, seconded. Any errors, additions, or omissions?
Are we talking about this transcript?
Yeah.
Okay.
Couldn't find one error in that.
Just one on page 8 under, well, let's see. It's item 10 after roll call, and it would be the one second line up or third line up if you're counting the one word at the bottom. It says, since the application was withdrawn, he closed the public hearing 2802 and accepted withdrawal. I can't accept. It was I recommended.
Yep.
And then it carries on later. So just change and accepted is to recommended withdrawal. Anybody else?
No.
Hearing none, call a roll. as, this is as amended.
Charles Stern?
Four.
Elizabeth Ballard?
As amended.
Four?
Four.
I get it as a four.
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 Okay, thank you. Kathleen Sarno?
Four.
Peter Falk? Four. Lori Longy?
Four.
Nicholas Fagus?
Four.
Charles Land?
Four.
7-4, none against and no abstention. December 13th, special meeting.
Make a motion to approve minutes for special meeting December 13th, 2014.
Second.
Motion's made and seconded. Any errors, additions, or omissions?
I have a question on the people who were present. Elizabeth Ballard wasn't present. She came in when...
No, I was there. The Saturday meeting?
Yes.
Came in at the very end.
You came in at the very end. We'd already voted and everything before you came in.
So her time is off. Just check the time.
Oh, that's the one I came in at 9:05 and the meeting was
already done. Yeah. It was that quick.
Well, you couldn't have done it because we met at yeah, I guess we did.
Yeah, we did.
We could, yeah.
Put my name
yeah, but we called, it says we called the order at 10.
I mean, it's fine. I'm just saying she was not present for the meeting, right. So.
Well, for the vote anyway.
Yeah, or for the vote.
Okay. Okay, then. This is, anything further? For the minutes then, for December 13th, as amended, call the roll.
Charles Duren?
Four.
Elizabeth Ballard?
Oops,
you could vote for the minutes, if you want. Yeah, there's no problem with voting as long as you agree with it.
But you're telling me I wasn't there until the meeting was over.
Well, then vote abstain. I'm not going to...
I'm abstaining because I wasn't there, but I...
Abstain.
Elizabeth Ballard abstains. Kathleen Sarno?
Four.
Peter Falk? Four. Lori Longy?
Abstain.
Nicholas Fagus?
Four.
Charles Land?
Four.
Was Ronald Gregory there?
Yes.
Yeah?
Four.
Yeah?
Ronald was there.
Yeah. Can he vote tonight, though?
He can't.
No, he can't.
Okay. But he was there.
Unless one of these... Okay, unless one of them withdrew, but that's all right. It doesn't make any difference. It passes. We're 5-0-2. Okay, we got that straight. And the last one for this evening is December 18th. It's a regular meeting.
Make a motion to approve the regular meeting for Thursday, December 18th, 2014.
Second.
Any errors, additions, or omissions?
I don't think I had any. I didn't see any. That's because...
Well, the only thing is is page 21. Unresolved issues. It was enforcement signs for Mount Carmel Show and other car shows. It's not the signs. It's the show itself.
The signs and the shows, I guess.
Yeah. And car shows in general, because they did not come in and have approval. Okay. So, it's enforcement, signs, maybe /
approval.
And show, maybe. And
car shows, not just Mount Carmel.
Car shows?
Yes. Yes, that Mount Carmel show shouldn't be in there. That was just one of the ones that was being held. There were two of them that should have been enforced. Or not, it's all they have to do is come in, and once they maintain the same position, they don't have to come back in. It's administrative approval automatically. There were two of them that we complained about that hadn't come in. Okay. Motion's been made, and call the roll for the minutes as amended.
Charles Duren?
Four.
Elizabeth Ballard?
Jane.
Kathleen Sarno?
Four.
Peter Falk? Four. Lori Longy?
Four.
Nicholas Fagus?
Four.
Charles Land?
Four.
And you had, so that is 601. Okay, and now almost a complete set. January 8th, regular meeting.
Make a motion to approve the regular meeting January 8th, 2015.
Second.
Motion's made and seconded. Any errors, additions, or omissions?
Looks like a pretty clean job to me, but.
They were, I did see one of those two words that were combined on page 3. In the paragraph after the interim planner, 6 lines down after Commissioner Falk, it says the approval of. Those two words were just together. That was the only thing I saw. But that, I think, is just that formatting issue. It's not a.
Well, I do see.
Excuse me, there's
two spaces.
There's one more.
Just above it.
Just yeah. Above it. And effective. Oh. First two words.
Oh, yes. Mm. Yep.
Okay, just on page 15, it's just verbiage. It's third line from the bottom. They is, it should be, they are already serving the same material.
But they is.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, any further additions, errors, or omissions? Hearing none, take the roll for the minutes as amended.
Charles Duren.
4.
Elizabeth Ballard.
Abstain.
Kathleen Sarno.
4.
Peter Falk. 4. Lori Longy.
4.
Michael Sapakis.
Abstain.
Charles Land.
4.
I read them.
Now what have we got? What was the vote, Peter?
Who abstained?
Nick.
Liz.
Oh.
And
Liz and Nick. Two abstentions.
Oh, that's, okay.
So it's 5-4 and two abstentions. 5-4,
none against, and two abstentions. Okay, very. I think we only have one outstanding, October 2nd. We're clearing them up.
Yeah.
Good. Intern town planner.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I have quite a few items to go through, but I'll try to get through them as quickly as possible, because we have a lot of business tonight. First one is Mike Linares of Whirly Ball has come to us about pursuing a liquor permit with the state for a restaurant permit for catering establishment. It's under authority of the Connecticut General Statutes, and as you know, a lot of what is authorized by the statutes for the state is not necessarily in your regulations, so it is not. The idea is a catering on premises with liquor. It's not catering off premises. For one thing, catering is, you know, it's not permitted in this zone. It's allowed only in the industrial zone. And this, there are only 5 types of liquor permits, and this does not fit into any one of them. So my advice to Mr. Linares is, if he wishes to talk to you about it, he should send you a letter describing what he wants, and then you would decide at that point how you want to proceed.
We have planning meetings, and you'd be welcome to come into a planning meeting. I don't know when we'd get them on. We'd have to take a look at what we've got.
Okay. Second item, I reported on this earlier, the assisted living facility at Middle and Hazard. You should know that they have indicated to me that they have a contract with the property owner, and they're moving forward. Because of extensive wetlands on the property, we advise them that they really should do the delineation first before they even do a concept plan. And they've taken that advice, and they're pursuing that. Third one is 76 Hazard Avenue. And this is a proposal at a closed gas station at Hazard and Middle. It's, and it's a proposal by Jiffy Lube at the site. A teardown would be necessary, but the issue here is that it is not a permitted use in the BL zone. There are a lot of wetlands on the property, sort of undefined at this point, and it's barely outside the aquifer protection district, and so this kind of use would not be allowed. We'd have to define where that district line is. So,
it goes back a while. Is the pump still on that property, I know that they had a plume from that station, and I don't know if they're pumping at that location or if they're pumping over, because we had, they were doing a cleanup there, and they came in, if you can recall, when they were removing the pumps.
I don't have the answer to that, Mr. Chairman, but I can find out.
I don't know if the pumps are still working. The pumps were across Hazard Avenue on another property.
Okay. I will see what if I can find out and report the next meeting.
If there's still contamination, maybe. Have you checked with the person in charge of wetlands? I don't know who it might be today.
Oh, is it Joe Allen?
Who's the wetlands?
Oh, Jenny.
Jenny, okay.
Yes.
Okay. Check with Jenny.
Okay. I don't think this is going to go anywhere.
All right.
But we have a plan in front of us, and the person has been calling me, so I'll advise her.
Okay.
Next one is there is a pharmacy that's being proposed at 544 Hazard Avenue in Skidico, and it's at the intersection of Hazard and Skidico. They had a second ART on it. It is, they're calling it a generic pharmacy. They say they do not have a specific client. It looks to me like a very specific type of design. The application will be submitted for receipt at the second meeting in February. It will be a site plan review. And there is, again, no specific company that's identified here.
I think I asked you, because that was brought up before, and maybe it was downstairs at the chairs. I don't know. There was a study of that area done by Capital Region that dealt with the major road problems in the area. And I said, I don't know if it was Peter was going to get a hold of it, but we should get a hold of it as a guide.
Okay.
But they did tell me there is a spot, there is a stoplight out there now, which does help. But I don't know if that was part of the study or not.
They're proposing improvements here. I'm not sure if they're improvements that were inspired by the study or consistent with the study, but we can find out as well.
Well, it should, because we, if that comes in, should have that study at hand so that we aren't. Okay.
Okay. Okay, this one is, we had another ART on Enfield Pizza. They would like to move to 112 Pearl Street. This is a site with the so-called castle building. And there is a condemned building right behind it that was residential. Plans to tear it down. He will use the first floor for a restaurant. There will be delivery pizza. Not
is that a residence at present?
It's a residence, okay, completely. So the first floor will be, the change of use.
Right, okay.
Okay. Okay, and there's, they're trying to provide as many parking spaces as possible.
Fine.
So on. Okay, Stop and Shop. This is new. They're proposing some pods. You probably heard about the Peapod service. You can go on the online. You can order things. This is sort of an extension of that. This is a little different. This is where they would actually have some containers that are up against the building. And what you can do is go on the internet, order your groceries. They will then be packed for you. And they will be put in a refrigerated pod, and it would be outside. And then there will be parking specifically for this use. You would not come to the curb with your car. The staff of the supermarket would then deliver your groceries to your car and then come back.
Okay,
that's the concept.
Just a quickie on that too. They came in, as most of them do, for outside displays, seasonal displays, and they have a set locations. Would they have to? Well,
I think this is an extension of their business, and I think it's something that should be a modification of some kind.
Right, I know, but it would take place of this other, probably.
But they would come in.
We'll find that out when
yes.
they come in.
Yeah, they'll find out.
Yeah,
yeah.
I'm
okay. I'm just heads up. That,
okay.
Okay. Okay. Fine.
Okay. Next one is that there is a professional massage therapist who wishes to occupy a unit at a commercial condo at 75 Hazard Avenue. The uses in this commercial condo, you know, have included nail and hair salons, driving school, mostly business services in this particular location. You know, certainly a professional massage therapist would be a service. And so it would seem to me that that could be something that could go in there without a change of use. However, per the town ordinance, they have to satisfy quite a few requirements, you know, concerning their background and so on with the town manager, and this is by ordinance. And that comes first before zoning. You know, at this point, staff is thinking that because of the uses that have been in here, this seems like a service use and therefore would not be a change of use.
Should probably come in anyways.
Okay, thank you. Okay, and then another thing that just came in the door, and this is just very conceptual at this point, is a 3-lot standard commercial subdivision on 34.18 acres. And it's located in a business professional zone between 117 and 137 Hazard. And, you know, to be more specific, it's the second lot down from the Country Diner on the same side of the road. A lot of wetlands on this property. It's going to go to the ART. The applicant's name is Elzier Roy. There are three lots on it with three concept plans for commercial type development, a fitness building, a health club, and a generic building. But there are no clients here. Okay. I think they're all speculative. Extensive wetlands. There's a new 880 foot new road, a very large conservation easement that on the plan is isolated. They have a very long way to go. And the wetlands are so extensive here, it may be extremely difficult. Okay. Another one, this is on the same road. Other side of the street, more towards, past the Country Diner, proposed Hooks Fish Fry and Grill. It's extremely conceptual. They propose to convert an existing wooden shack on the property and propose outside dining.
Gas station. Fireworks display.
Yeah, where they sell fireworks. Yeah. And furniture.
Yeah. Driving range was there.
No, there's.
I think it's a wooden shack.
That there in the medical office facility. Mm-hmm. Well, just reminded, I don't think there's alcohol.
Right. It's okay. Okay. Next one is this keeps coming up. The fitness center at 25 Hazard Avenue. They now want to look at different standards for parking regulations in large malls, especially regional malls, and to see if there have been any changes as a result of changes in the market. You know, for instance, there's a shrinkage of certainly retail stores. There's a lot of online, purchasing that's going on, and it's affecting, malls. And what they want to find out is, is this affecting standards around the state? Is there actually any study out there that suggests that the standards are high and should come down? But that's an approach that they want to take at this time. Yeah, our parking standards, which are, five per thousand for this.
And what are they supposed to affect?
I'm sorry?
Are parking standards effective?
Yeah, but they could not, right now they can't meet the parking standards. They would have to go down to 4.5 in order to meet them. Okay, and so.
Because they want to move into a mall.
Because they want to move into this mall.
Oh, I see. All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
They should probably come in for a planning meeting, not a.
So. Yeah, that would be a planning meeting.
Yeah. Yeah, this is informational only at this point.
Yeah, all right. Yeah. Okay.
Okay, and I think you know about the food vending issue.
As soon as you finish, I have some things for you.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Okay. It's just that there have been a lot of complaints about food vending at the Powder Hollow Brewery, and I was asked by administration to render an interpretation of the zoning regulations relative to vending. Not a legal opinion, but just an interpretation,
right.
And I provided that.
We got those tonight.
Yes.
Okay.
And that's all I have for the moment, Mr. Chairman.
Since the food trucks has come up, and we discussed the comments at the food trucks at the chair's meeting last night, would you arrange for, and you could do the towns out of state if you want, but we want comparable towns to Enfield.
Yes, okay.
Their zoning regulations, and as many as you can get a hold of, please.
Okay. And this is comparable by population or size?
Both.
Okay.
Secondly, a separate definition for two items. The catering trucks are the trucks that stay, let's say, 10 minutes and move. The ones that they used to visit the mills down here, or they go into the gas stations and they're in and out.
Canteen.
And the canteen ones. And the stationary vehicles.
Right.
Because they're two different types. But as long as we're looking at one, we've got to look at both.
There are actually many types out there.
Well, those are them all. If there are others,
The reason why I passed on regulation from Bolton is because I spent about a year helping to draft a regulation. And
well,
no matter what the size of the town, they're still dealing with some of the same issues.
But you have the permanent trucks or the trucks that are there for more than an hour or whatever time we select at the time. And then the trucks that are just coming in to service the people that are going to have their break. And actually, they also have to have permission from the owner of the property and so on and so forth. So those would be two separate regulations that we would have to go through.
Mm-hmm.
And I hope the people are aware of that. And they, again, these probably should be topped because it's caused a lot of discussion. And that should be the top of the next planning meeting if we can get all the material together.
Okay.
But I know we have somebody coming in. Peter's just came in.
We for the next planning session, we have the parking plan.
Sorry. Okay. Well, we could at least start on this if we have any material.
Yeah.
And how about the solar?
And the solar people are coming as well. And it's the February 12th date.
We had them online before this happened, so this takes third position, I guess. It's a planning workshop. So this would be third position on it then, but at least have the material ready. And if you can, please send it to us before the meeting, not at the meeting, so that we can have look at it before.
Mr. Chairman?
That should take care of that, yes.
You've probably seen some of the comments by the town attorney concerning three different amendments that you've been working on for some time, home husbandry and, let's see.
They should go on the agenda for the next meeting.
For the next meeting, for the 5th?
Absolutely, can't do them tonight.
We will do that. No, I understand that.
Okay. I'm sorry. Thank you very much for reminding me of that.
Okay.
And thank Peter for getting those where they're at.
Sorry, kind of got lost in my
system. It got lost with me because I asked Lori where they were and what had happened to them because I thought we'd already finished.
Well, we will push them along.
Thank you. Let's see now. Oh. Yep. Let me find at this point in the meeting, Planning and Zoning Commission welcomes comments, concerns, and opinions relating to planning and zoning in Enfield. From anyone who is present, provided no one may discuss any matter of business at this time that's already elsewhere in the agenda, any matter that's part of an open public hearing of the commission, or any matter where a decision of the commission may be pending. Is there anyone in the audience who would like to address the commission? Anyone else or anyone in the audience that would like to address the commission? Last call at this point to address the commission under those conditions. Hearing none, then we shall move on to Commissioner's correspondence. You, the only thing is, on you had the Planning Magazine, what was in there, great interest. You also have the Capital Region minutes of importance to us, and give some, take a look at your calendars, is the AquaTurf meeting that is coming up, and it's on Thursday, March 26th. And if any of you have between either 12 years or 25 years of service in a land use board, please let them know.
I think I do.
Yeah, I think you do now, because we talked about it.
Yeah.
So check out Peter, check out Kathy's.
Pretty soon it's going to be the whole commission.
They're pretty good. Well, it's a pretty good commission.
I don't have 12.
I have.
There's a couple nice articles in there that you, I'm sure you read.
Yep.
Separation distance, and boy, that affects us if that's the way they measure by the crow.
Yeah, but I think I read that too. It was if you didn't have anything of how you measured in your reg,
yes,
they measured the straight line.
But we
measured, we have a way.
We measured door to door, out to the main street and down and back into the door. And that, I believe, is it. I don't think we have to notify yet who can attend, but they want you to take a look at your at the meeting dates and try to pencil that in so we could go. And Commissioner's correspondence, anything you want to report on last night at Chairs or not?
Actually, I attended the Economic and Community Development meeting as the liaison from the Planning and Zoning, and there was a lot of informational materials from Peter, actually, from about the Transit Center, and they're planning to do a seminar or a business workshop in the summer, and a few other events. And then last night, Charlie and I attended the Council of Chairs meeting, and that seemed to go very well, with a lot of discussion on Thompsonville and other issues that the other chairs had.
The other meeting that we should report on is the last planning meeting. Peter, do you want to do it? Well, basically, we did finish the Thompsonville area north of Alden Avenue. And basically, what they're doing is you will get a clean copy, which we've asked for, so we don't have all this go back and forth. So as soon as Peter gets it, and don't wait for a meeting, Peter, please get it out. Okay.
Sure.
Yep. As soon as we get it, please give us the clean copy. Give it to us much before. Please read it, and so that we can get that done and under our regulations, so we can start on the others. We're starting on the others anyway.
Right.
Will do.
Okay. Thank you. Anything further? That's it. Okay. Then let's move on. Public hearing continued from January 8th. Special use permit, request a change for use for the Montessori school to relocate to the Felician Sisters, located at 1325 Enfield Street, in HR 33 District. Secretary, please take the roll.
Charles Duran.
He's present.
Elizabeth Ballard.
Here.
Kathleen Sarno.
Here.
Peter Falk. Here. Lori Longy.
Here.
Nicholas Fakis.
Here.
Charles Ladd.
Here.
Tom Gregory?
Yeah.
Alan Drinan?
Not here.
Seven present, and
one alternate.
Okay, and is the applicant here, if they'll come forward?
And I'd just like to state that I was not at the last meeting, but I did read the minutes and am up to speed.
So we've come with a very similar presentation.
If you will sit down and identify yourself,
I
right?
Apologize.
Just, that's it. Okay. Welcome back.
Feel welcome. Thank you. Peter Bachman, principal with JCJ Architecture, architect of record, and a Connecticut licensed architect. We've come with a very similar presentation that we made here on January 8th with two small drawing changes in that presentation, which were all part of the package that you've got. If you'd like, because I know not all of you were here, we could make the same presentation once again.
Well, if you want to do a summary, you can, but it's not. It's probably not necessary. The ones that were absent declared that they watched the tapes or have read the material, so it's not necessary.
Do you want to say something?
Sure.
Oh, you're welcome to say, and I do open it to the public, so.
Thank you. My name is Cleana Bolio, and I am the head of school of Enfield Montessori School. I want to thank you so very much for all the consideration that you've given this application. And I did want to just tell you just a little bit about the school and what an asset it is to the town of Enfield. As you may know, the Enfield Montessori School has been serving families in Enfield and the surrounding town since 1965. In fact, the highest percentage of our students do come from the town of Enfield, but every day we also have families coming from 22 other towns that come into the town of Enfield sometimes three times a day where they shop and they eat. These families come so their children can be in a school that promotes hands-on, self-paced, collaborative, engaged, meaningful, and joyful learning. A good Montessori education prides itself on innovation rather than standardization, and we think our school is pretty good. Enfield Montessori has had a tremendous working relationship with the town. Many of the town services, including the Enfield Public Schools, and we're really appreciative of the part that we play in the Enfield community. We are heavily involved in outreach to the Enfield town. We provide ongoing support to Loaves and Fishes, to the Enfield Food Shelf, and to, you know, other individual causes as we feel that we can help. This project will hopefully be completed during our 50th anniversary year, which is very exciting for us. During these 50 years, we've had over 1,200 students pass through our doors. We're very proud not only of the caliber of student that we produce, but more importantly, the quality of their character and the philanthropy that they show to the communities that they go out to. Our school strives to be available to all families. In fact, our tuition rates are about 300% lower than any of our competitive private schools. And over 35% of our families receive tuition assistance. This project will allow us to continue providing the quality education that we have become known for. Our school prides itself on helping children learn independence, leadership, self-discipline, responsibility, initiative, and a lifelong love of learning. And now maybe we'll be able to continue this tradition in a beautiful space that the children deserve. And we hope that you think the same thing too. So thank you so much.
Anything else? Any questions from the commission? Okay, and then I'll open it to the public. Anyone in the public would like to speak in favor or against this application? Anyone in the public would like to speak in favor or against the application? Last call to speak in favor or against this application. Hearing none, John or Peter, whichever one, any reason to keep it open? Okay.
I see no reason to keep this open, okay. Mr. Chairman.
Then I will close public hearing 2813. What's the desire of the commission?
I'd like to make a motion that we waive the following sections of the site plan requirements in Section 10 of the zoning ordinance in connection with this application of the Felician Sisters. And they are listed in a memo. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. They're listed in a memo by John Pagini, dated January 14, 2015.
Second.
Motion's made and seconded. Discussion?
Could we just add on the general condition number 16?
Wait a minute. We're on
just
the waiver.
Waive the
waiver. Okay. Okay. Sorry.
No discussion?
Oh, Mr. Chair?
Yes.
I was absent at the last meeting, but I reviewed the material and feel I can vote on this.
Okay. Hearing no, nothing, then call a roll.
Charles Stern?
For the waiver.
Elizabeth Ballard?
For.
Kathleen Sarno?
For.
Peter Falk? For. Lori Longhi?
For.
Nicholas Fakis?
For.
Charles Ladd?
For.
Motion passes 7-0-0.
I'd like to make a motion to approve the application of Felician Sisters of North America Real Estate Trust for a change of use and adaptive reuse of Felician's Heritage Library as a Montessori school located at 27.95 acres of land at 1325 Enfield Street in an HR 33 zone in accordance with reference plans as noted on John Puccini's memo dated January 14th, 2015. And there are 21 conditions.
Second.
Listed.
Motion's made and seconded. The application, the applicant have any problem with the conditions?
We do not.
Okay. We want to add that one word in. On condition number 16, there was a word missing, and the second line, change in the nature of the use, and it should be site or the structure, and the word site is missing. It's in the above line, but it's not in that line.
So use, comma, site.
Site, yeah.
Or the structure.
Yeah.
16, Lori?
Any problems with that? Okay.
16.
Okay, okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any further, any discussion on the motion? Hearing none, take the roll.
Charles Stern?
Four.
Elizabeth Ballard?
Four.
Kathleen Sarno?
Four.
Peter Falk, four. Lori Longhi?
Four.
Nicholas Fakis?
Four.
Charles Ladd?
Four.
Reasons?
I would like to comment that be glad to see that the new parking and unloading situation is better. Sister won't have to be out in the middle of Route 5 directing traffic. I've often worried about her getting run over.
I think it's a good reuse of an existing building in town with more space, and it was a nice plan.
It's in accordance with the master plan of development and conservation.
Yeah. And thank you for such a good job of getting everything, all your stuff together in one package.
It is
here.
Right.
We're all working for the same cause here.
Wish everybody thought that way. I'm sure you're very happy with it, but I'm sure the children will be as equally happy. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your consideration. Thanks for your
time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. The new public hearing, XCA 15-04. Please read the legal notice and take the roll.
The Enfield Planning and Zoning Commission will hold public hearings on Thursday, January 22, 2015, beginning at 7 p.m. in the Town Hall Council Chambers, 820 Enfield Street, Enfield, Connecticut, concerning the following. XZA 15-01, the proposed text amendment to Section 4.50.7, modifications to swimming pools. And it was an initiative of the Enfield Planning and Zoning Commission. This notice was published in the Journal Enquirer on January 10th, 2015, and January 15th, 2015. Roll call, Charles Stern.
Here.
Elizabeth Ballard.
Here.
Kathleen Sarno.
Here.
Peter Falk. Here. Lori Longhi.
Here.
Nicholas Fakis.
Here.
Charles Ladd.
Here.
Ronald Gregory.
Here.
Alan Drynan.
Okay. The applicant is the town, so either John or Peter, just briefly explain what it is we're doing.
Mr. Chairman, for the record, John Puccini, interim town planner. The purpose of this amendment, which is to add a new subsection E, was to ensure that in-ground swimming pools and principal structures could be allowed. Right now, the only kinds of swimming pools that are in ground were allowed as accessory structures, which are separate from the principal structure. So this would allow them within a principal structure. And I also want to note that the Capital Region Council of Government has said that there's no apparent conflict with regional plans and policies or the concerns of neighboring towns. In a memo dated January 20th, 2015, from Lynn Pike DeSanto.
Any questions for the applicant?
No. Pretty straightforward.
Okay, then no, any reason to keep it open?
No, Mr. Chairman.
Hearing none, I'll close public. Anyone in the public would like to speak in favor or against this application? Please come forward, sir. Name and address.
My name is Bob LaFlame, 337 Elm Street, and I'm in favor of this.
Thank you. Anyone else would like to speak in favor or against? Anyone else would speak in favor or against? Last call to speak in favor or against. And I will close the public hearing, XEA 1501.
I'll make a motion to accept the proposed text amendment for XZA 15-01, modifications to swimming pools.
Second.
Motion's made and seconded. Any discussion?
Looks like a good idea.
Secretary, please take the call the roll.
Charles Stern?
Four.
Elizabeth Ballard?
Four.
Kathleen Sarno?
Four.
Peter Falk? Four. Lori Longhi?
Four.
Nicholas Fakis?
Four.
Charles Ladd?
Four.
700. This takes, fixes a hole in our regulations that actually didn't allow this type of thing, which sort of was foolish and really makes things whole for several people, I guess, in town, or makes it easier for people to have an enclosed swimming pool.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
I would also like to recommend an effective date for this.
Oh, thank you.
And that date would be February 10th.
2015.
The effective date is February 10th, 2015. Okay.
Do I have to revise my?
You want no?
No, I don't think you really have to revise your motion.
Okay, we'll just say that concerning because we're not on anything right now. Well, you know, is it on this? This is passed.
Never mind.
All right. Okay. Okay. 2814. Special use permit redevelopment of it. I guess we're ready.
We didn't vote.
What?
Did we?
We did.
Oh, we did. Yeah. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. I was like, after she. All right. Because I was thinking, why couldn't Liz ask her question then
because
after we voted?
Done. It was everything was done.
Yeah.
I made the motion and. Second.
Okay.
Sorry, I got it.
That's all right. Public hearing 2814. If the applicant's here, please get set up. And when you get up here, introduce yourself after the secretary takes reads a legal notice and takes a roll.
The Enfield Planning and Zoning Commission will hold public hearings on Thursday, January 22nd, 2015, beginning at 7 p.m. in the Town Hall Council Chambers, 820 Enfield Street, Enfield, Connecticut, concerning the following. Public hearing 2814, special use permit for the redevelopment. This says if, it should be of, an existing McDonald's restaurant located at 28 Hazard Avenue, map 56, lot number 0022. McDonald's USA LLC applicant, Equity One Northeast Portfolio Inc. is the owner. And this was published in the Journal Inquirer on January 10th, 2015 and January 15th, 2015. And the roll call, Charles Duren,
here.
Elizabeth Ballard,
here.
Kathleen Sarno,
here.
Peter Falk, here. Lori Longhi,
here.
Nicholas Fakis,
here.
Charles Ladd,
here.
Ron Gregory,
here.
Alan Drinan.
Okay. The applicant, please introduce yourselves. And
good evening. My name is Michelle Carlson. I'm a licensed professional engineer with BL Companies located at 355 Research Parkway in Meriden, Connecticut. With me this evening is Matt Bruton. He also works at BL Companies. He's a staff engineer, project engineer. And to my right, your left, is Sean Palmer. He's with McDonald's USA LLC. We're here this evening on behalf of the McDonald's, the shopping plaza owner, and the operator of the McDonald's. It is at 28 Hazard. I'm sure you all know where it is. It's about 30 years old. It's kind of tired, and McDonald's likes to update their restaurants as they get tired and worn so that the customers have a better experience. They want to update it and put new state-of-the-art equipment that'll be more environmentally, you know, efficient, and it'll be better for the customers and the employees. The current, I have up here just a couple of photos just so we can show you what the exterior looks like right now. This is looking from 28 Hazard right at the McDonald's. You can see the flagpole.
We can't see it on the screen.
Oh, it's not down. We don't know what you're talking about. They've got to switch it.
We don't have it on.
If they'll switch it at the, oh, is it you?
Oh, it's not us. It's in the
control room. Control please room. Switch your. There you go.
Can you see it now? I'm sorry.
No, it's not you. It's our control room.
You probably know it with your eyes closed, anyways. But yeah. It's this is looking right from Hazard Ave toward the McDonald's. You can see the mansard roof, the flagpole, the light poles. Go ahead, Matt, to the next one. Go to the other photo, please. There, another view of the drive-through. And I think there's one more, of the landscaping, which is the internal landscaping is lacking. It's not very nice. We'll go back to the existing conditions plan. The site is a 4,840 thereabouts square foot building. There's 66 parking spaces, and it's on a 1.3 leased parcel. So the area, the dashed black is actually the lease line. It's part of the Brookside Plaza. The entrance is to the right off of Hazard Avenue, Route 90. There's no direct access to the McDonald's from the road. You have to go into the shopping center. We are not proposing to disturb anything on the perimeter of that black line, except where we're going to connect to the water, where we have to dig through the green space. But we're preserving the front streetscape as it is. There's a pretty nice buffer from Hazard Avenue to the McDonald's. What we're proposing is a slightly smaller building. It's 4,680 square feet. It has a double drive-through, which is more efficient for the customer. It's not going to mean that there's going to be more people coming to the McDonald's. They're just going to process the people that are there more efficiently. The difference here also is they add a third window. And I know John and I had some discussion on this, and he can weigh in. He actually visited one of the other McDonald's. But what they do is the first window, go back to the site plan, just point to where the windows are. The first window is where you pay for your food. Then you pull up to the second window and you pick up your order. There is a third window, but it's not to process customers, you know, one after another. The third window is for if there's a delay in an order, say there's a large order that comes through or somebody's order gets messed up, they have that car pull forward to that window to wait. And it's safer for everybody because people can still get out of the drive-thru from the second window as they're picking up their food. And the employees don't have to come out and cross the parking lot, whether it's at night or whatever time of day. It's just a safer situation.
You have that same picture as an elevation, though, rather than
yes, I do.
Diagram.
I'm sorry. Go ahead. You want to go ahead and show that?
It much better.
Thank you. Go to the colored rendering.
Okay.
You can see it on the bottom, actually, the very bottom. You can see the first window is the pay window. The second window is where you pick up your order. And then the third window to the right by the BL logo is where you would wait if there was a delay in your order for some reason. It's more of it's a convenience for the customer and the employee.
Why does that window look bigger than the other?
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Twice as big.
Sean Palmer?
Sure. There is a fixed transom window. So it's a similar drive-through window as the other two windows, but there's a fixed transom window on the side. It just increases visibility for any of our crew members so that they can see a little bit better whenever that vehicle is pulling up.
Go ahead.
Why would you have that window? I mean, why wouldn't you not have it on the other windows? I guess is my question. Why is it different?
So, it's just visibility. Since that window, we don't always have vehicles pulling up to that window. It's not an expectation that our customers would constantly be pulling to that third window. So if there's somebody in that window, again, it just helps with like the visibility of the line of sight to see when a vehicle's sitting there.
Is it that one down more towards the service line? rather than the other two are in the back work area.
Right, in the kitchen area, right. You wouldn't want to have a window there because you have equipment and other stuff there. Okay, thank you.
I guess I have a question, too. I saw that. I had little notes because there's no markings.
Would you put that back up, please?
Like, there's no pavement markings for
that
people?
That one that you just had, because that's what
we
she's
lost
going to
our
refer
screen
to.
Again.
Well, it's not you? Okay, there it is. Thank you.
I noticed that there was no pavement markings, really, like, people just go through. If they're stopping, they're just told to pull up ahead, and people are just assumed to go around them?
I believe on the site plan there is a pavement marking as far as a stop sign and a stop.
Yeah, but how do you keep
line?
Them? I think she's saying, how do you keep them in that queue?
Yeah.
Just tell them to wait.
Well, they're told at the second window to pull forward to the next window and wait for their order.
Saying they can come out here, or just move around.
Right. Yeah. If someone's waiting there, they'll come out. This guy.
I guess I was looking. I didn't see the markings, and I'm more concerned about in the past when we have drive-thrus that we have people coming out that door. And you've got people waiting there, and then they get their food or whatever, and then they just, you know, take off, basically.
There is a stop bar, and there's a handrail, too.
I saw the handrail, but a lot of times we would have, like, crosswalk markings so that people would know, because you're going back into the majority of your parking lot. That's why I just didn't see any pavement stuff, unless it was on a different page. I was on SP1.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to right now. Yeah, we could add a crosswalk there. I mean, pavement markings. If it would make it better, we can definitely stripe that so that people are more aware that there's a painted crosswalk across.
Yeah, that. No and problem. I was looking for that on
yeah,
the
no,
plans,
that's fine.
And I didn't. Okay,
that's,
I didn't
that's
see
not
it.
A problem.
Okay.
Can't be too safe, so.
That's a very good point.
Yeah. Well, as long as we got that one out. Well, is this the same one? Yeah. As long as, same thing on this plan, and I had picked out before, your handicap are about the same way they are now, and having a handicap, it's a problem, because your handicap is really not near that entrance. And your ramp is there. It's a problem with it now. Your handicap's down near the back door. Plus, I don't know how you can correct it.
We're on SP1.
Yeah, that's what I'm looking at. When
you're backing out into the drive-thru. Actually, this is the drive-thru. And actually, that's the way the Elm Street one is designed, too. And I'll tell you, they come whipping around that corner, and you've got to be very careful if you're backing out of those handicapped. I don't know what you can do about it unless you got a sign and say cars backing out or something. I don't know. You may not have any accidents over there. I really don't know if we have an accident report on that anyway. But it is tough to back out of those, especially when these people are in a rush to get around and get into the line.
See, I looked at, like, on that plan, the handicap ramp is actually in the queue to get the double lanes.
No.
Mr. Chairman?
I'll answer your question when you're ready. I'm sorry.
Okay. I can answer that.
Yes.
I think that was the impression that I had when I looked at it first. That is not the case. In fact, the entire sidewalk going up to the front door is in fact a 12-to-1, slope. Which is which meets the handicap accessible requirements, the federal requirements.
But where's the entrance?
The entrance is in the middle of the handicap.
In the middle.
It's in the middle.
That walk is for the trucks when they're doing their deliveries. They unload the truck and they need to go up that ramp to get into the building to deliver product.
So your actual entrance to the handicap ramp, you just go right from the car up to the...
Yeah, go put the
It's right here in front
okay.
of you.
Okay,
it's
all right.
This is a door here.
It's the middle door, the middle elevation?
It's the middle of the three. Yes.
Okay. Perfect. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. That's all that.
And it's all flush.
Okay, that
okay.
was good.
Is that great?
Okay.
Yeah,
it's
that
all
makes
flush.
A big difference.
That makes
okay.
a lot of difference. Okay.
And they are closest to the main entrance, which
okay.
they
right.
need to be.
Okay. Because I know the one on Elm, the one there now. I park in the non-handicap one, really. It's much easier to get to the entrance. Okay. Continue if you are.
Those are just on those pages.
No. Keep asking questions.
No, go ahead. We will as you go.
We are, for utilities, we're connecting to all the existing utilities. All the utilities are available on the site, gas, water, electric, storm, sewer. We're adding a new grease trap on the outside of the store. Landscaping, we're increasing the interior landscaping, if you want to go to the landscaping plan, by 7% about. There's not a lot of interior landscaping there now. We are increasing the interior landscaping. We're putting 9 trees, deciduous trees, in the interior. Right now there's 0.
Yeah.
So we are adding a considerable amount of interior landscaping. We're adding landscaping also on the perimeter. Can you go to the cursor over here? In this area, we're adding perimeter landscaping. Combination of arborvitaes, grasses, perennials. We are screening the inside, the middle. You could go to the right there. We're putting shrubs and screening so that from Hazard Avenue, you can't see any of the transformer or any of the back house operations. One thing I forgot to point out on the site plan, but I'm sure you all saw, was the location of the dumpster.
Yeah.
Right now, the dumpster is in the middle of the island behind the building,
in the
way of the drive-through.
Yeah.
It's not accessed a lot, and it's accessed off hours, so we put it off to the side so that it's not in conflict with traffic.
And that's screened.
Right. They didn't see what it was screened.
We ran a photometric plan. Complete cutoff lighting, dark zero, dark sky. We have the photometric plan as part of the application. We're putting new poles, new structures. I mean, everything inside that black line is going to be new. Everything's coming out. There's nothing that we're saving.
Is it closing down while you're doing
it? Yeah, and it takes about 90 days to tear down and renovate. There's been some that have been a little bit longer because they're bigger, and there's some that was a record 66 days a couple months ago. So it just depends.
And all the vehicles for demolition, anything like that, is all going to be contained in the McDonald's area, or is anything going in the parking lot?
They're going to stage inside the McDonald's area. I don't believe they're going to stage in the parking lot of the plaza.
Nothing's going in the regular.
No, we will not. Everything will be within the McDonald's demise line that you're seeing.
Okay. If you look on the site plan, too, you'll notice, I'm sure you have, that we're keeping the existing road sign. We're not messing with that. We're leaving that alone. We're keeping the flagpole. That just goes back to we want to keep as much as we can out front the same with the streetscape, because we think the streetscape actually looks good.
Yeah. Would you, and you haven't, and maybe I'll get you off your presentation, but you have several boards there, and I noticed the first one we come to is a pre-sell board.
Correct.
And it's in the middle of the queue, there is one or some labeled. So that I guess if I was on the inside, I'd have to have a passenger to talk to it, or
It's just a sign. It's a pre-sell board. The order boards are actually, you pull forward, and there's two order boards, one for each lane.
They have to pass it. Okay. Yeah. And then you have two order boards, or where are they?
Yes, two order boards, one on each side of the double drive-through, so that the outside lane has its own.
Well, that's what I was looking for.
Yeah.
Okay. They're both on the left of the cars? All right.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Oh, yeah.
Okay, so they do that, but then what's up above? There was something, another pit
this
fixture.
This is the actual board, I believe, that they look at with all the prices on it.
Okay.
Right. Provide an install menu board.
Right, okay. That's the menu
that's
board.
The menu board.
Okay.
Drive, right here, pay, over here, pick up.
How, and that's yours, but how do you keep track, if I'm in the outside queue, how do you keep track of whose order is what on this?
It's computerized by which board you're ordering from, so they can keep track of inside. They know the car queue and how it's coming along and which board was just placed the order.
Yeah, but then how's the car, I mean.
Yes,
it's amazing.
There's a lot of technology that goes into
it. Okay, all right. I didn't know if I was in that line, if
I can understand that. Two people place their order at exactly the same time.
Okay.
The computer thinks car A is coming, but car B cuts in front of them.
Now you're really overanalyzing it.
It could happen because they're queuing up, and I don't know. Oh, I see.
What typically happens, a lot of times that there's two order points, but usually there's one order taker. So they're interchanging the orders. And the system does is it so that we don't get a car confused. Say if one car would cut in front of the other or do something, try to speed through their order, the computer actually takes a photo of the vehicle, and that way whenever the order comes up.
Okay. All right. Well, that's what I was asking.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'm just curious because they're way before the windows that they're getting in line again.
And I did notice that you have a feature that most people don't have, and that's telephone still outside in the parking lot. Because there's still an old-fashioned telephone box out there.
Yes.
I don't know if it works, but it's there.
I was just going to say, have you ever seen anybody use it?
No.
The architecture of the building is good. We have Sean has to show you, too.
Okay, great. While he's getting those out, on the roof mechanics in the screening, all right. Would you explain where they are and what they are? I saw the end of mechanics on the designs, but are they, in other words, behind the parapet? So
except for the transformer, obviously, on the ground. The other HVAC equipment and mechanical equipment is on the roof, screened by the parapet.
Okay.
Charlie, look, they're earth tones.
Yeah, great. I know. Okay. Oh, boy. Let's look this one for a while.
Wasn't taking that's any good. Chances.
Those are nice colors. Yeah.
That's the cultured stone. I mean, if you want to talk to the materials, go ahead.
Sure. So the ledger stone that you have there, that is on the front of what you can tell is what we call our arcades. So it'll be all around the arcades where the stonework is. The I don't know which one was next, the gray or the cityscape gray. So that is the color. That will be the color of all of the trellises going around and over the drive-through, and then it will also be the metal corrugated metal above that you're seeing on top of the parapet wall. And then the yellow, that's our brand color, which you'll see the awnings, and then obviously the color of the brick would be the remaining exterior facade.
I have a question. Is that really stone, or is it a composite of some kind?
It is a stone. It's a ledge stone.
On the elevations that you just had up, I noticed you had the front of the building faces Hazard Avenue, but on the chart or on the things, I think you had the eastern front of the building is laid at the front. Is that
correct? Okay. Is it still on the screen?
They keep moving it. Please put it back. There you go. Okay.
I mean, we can walk the computer
by.
We're calling the front elevation faces the driveway on Brookside Plaza. You're in the driveway.
Please. If you should come back in again, instead of front, side, back, and so forth, is
north, south,
north,
east,
south,
and
east, and west.
That's why I'm an engineer and didn't prepare the elevations. I agree. The non-drive-through side elevation is actually what you see on Hazard.
Right. Okay.
It's going to be, personally, I think it's going to look a lot nicer. It's just going to clean up the site.
No, but all those in the back end there didn't have the directions. So you had to sort of move them around, especially when you said the front is the east. Okay.
Yeah, you're looking at A2.0, right?
Yes.
The front elevation, right,
and
is the east.
Right,
the non-drive-through is the north elevation.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're stuck here for the night.
Is that it?
I mean, I don't have anything else unless you have.
No, I don't know.
I want to know what the color was the dumpster.
Ah, yes. Go ahead. We have that.
Oh, okay.
You have either a saddle or a Madeira to work off of the building, and whatever you would prefer. It's we'll do either.
Whatever blends best with the building.
Yeah, yeah, what would you, what really would you think?
I don't think it would matter. I mean, we could use whatever is locally available. You know, whether it's either of those. I think that either of those would blend. You know, the reason
either of those, I'm okay with. But
okay.
Did you get to see the color? Do you have that?
Yes.
Okay, because I have a piece of paper.
Yeah, we just saw that. Okay. That we did
all
see.
Right.
I mean, that was fine. It was just there was no color listed, okay. So I didn't know if it was white or,
It'll be one of those two colors, and if you don't have a preference, we would probably go with what we can, what we can get.
Yeah.
No problem.
At the time.
And that dumpster is basically on the opposite side of, I know Taco Bell is right there, and it seemed as though it was similar placement beside where theirs was.
Yes.
Okay.
Do you have to have two or large enough for two dumpsters in there? Are you, in other words, are you separating cardboard and paper?
Two. Yeah, they usually have two.
That's okay. Yeah. I know that most places have switched. I didn't know. If,
right.
Okay.
I was just curious. I see some discussion in here from the ART December 3rd, some of the bike racks. Were all your issues resolved from that ART meeting?
There are still just a few outstanding issues. I can tell you that the bike racks, there's actually a place that's been designated there for a future bike rack. And the reason why we said future is because right now no one can legally get there on a bicycle. There are plans for Hazard Avenue to have some kind of bicycle and pedestrian access in the future. And I guess what we're suggesting is that when that happens, then the applicant should install a bike
they
rack.
They probably want to anyway.
Yeah. So it's shown on the plan. A location is shown on the plan, but not a specific, bike rack.
Mm-hmm.
There are. Do you want me to go over the other issues while I'm doing this?
Okay. Well, yes.
Okay. And I think one of the difficulties about this is that some of the standards in your regulations are not necessarily designed for a satellite facility that's in the middle of a regional shopping center. For instance, you have very adequate buffering on at least two sides, and really three sides of the site here. Two sides because of buffering requirements for the mall itself, and yet. There is in your site plan regulations, it requires a 10-foot landscape strip along the entire perimeter. Mm-hmm. And I guess what I'm asking is that something that you feel needs to be applicable within a development that's under unified ownership and control, which is what we're talking about here? Is that something that applies to the overall development itself, the development perimeter, which also includes the satellite, or does every site have to have that? Because we have, one portion of the site here that doesn't meet that. It's about 7 feet, not 10 feet. So that's one question. The other one is the same one that keeps being raised every time you have a drive-through, and that is the requirement that you have 10 feet of landscaping around the building. And frankly, if you're going to have a drive-through, you can't accomplish that at all. And I believe what you did was to make a finding on the last application that's something that doesn't apply because of the drive-through. Another issue while we're talking about the windows, again, your regulations perhaps aren't specific enough because under Section 1010.2, which is parking, it talks about drive-in and fast food restaurants and what parking is required there, and it says 10 stacking spaces for each service window. Now, if we are very literal here, we would have a ridiculous situation where you have 30 stacked spaces that are required. In my mind, there's an interpretation to be made here. I don't think that the cash, that where you pay for it, should be considered a service window. I think where you pick it up should be. And if you happen to have a minor overflow one where, let's say, a large order comes and, periodically maybe somebody has to wait over there, I don't think that should be counted either. I think in this particular case, you have one major service window. If you had two lanes and two separate windows, that would be different, but you don't. Another issue. Excuse me while I find this. Okay, the plans Okay, the plans depict specification details of message boards, and I just want to say that I was curious how one of these sites would work. Okay, and I heard that there was one, and it was on Spencer Street in Manchester. And so I went to see it at 5 o'clock one night. I thought maybe I could see the cars battling for the lane, but it didn't happen to be the peak hour at all. At most, there were two cars that were lined up. But it was also there that I noticed the windows, the three windows that were there, and also talked to the staff and understood then just how these windows really worked. And then we had confirmation from McDonald's later just how they worked. So I feel comfortable with the commission making that interpretation. Also, there is a very large, I guess it's, what is around the back of the building that needs to be screened? I mentioned that.
There's just
the transformer.
The transformer.
Yeah, well, in Manchester, their idea of shielding and transformers to put four yellow posts on each side and put a bunch of mulch on the ground.
I think we
have a different idea. And, as of this afternoon, we had a landscape plan that was still an older one. And so what I'm suggesting is, of course, that we have one that specifically buffers, that particular facility from view.
Just screen on it, right.
Yeah, yeah. Let's see, the specifications also, from my reading, they're fairly complex plans. They're very detailed, but I also noticed that there are wall sconces and what are called, accent lighting.
Right.
And those are LED lights. But what I'd like to clarify is that it appears that some of them are labeled up and down.
Right.
And some are labeled exclusively up and some exclusively down. And if this means that they are projecting upward at all, that is not in compliance with our regulations. They should all be projected downward. And so my recommendation is that if that is the case, that these lights need to all be projected downward.
They will be projected downward.
Yeah, we just had that on another application.
Two more issues. One has to do with comments from the fire marshal who wanted to ensure that their largest apparatus could maneuver around the site unobstructed. And, we just had an application where that was demonstrated very well right on the site plan. And so that's something that we would like to see as well. Or at least make it a condition of making it satisfactory to the fire marshal. And then finally, there was a comment by the assistant town engineer saying that the height of the flush concrete curb shall be increased to 8 inches. And perhaps you can help clarify what that is.
We left messages and haven't heard back, but whether it's 6 or 8, I mean, whatever he wants, we'll comply with.
Okay.
And we understand that there can be no uplighting. I mean, our photometric plan that we ran was run with downlighting. The elevation has, for some reason, called out on it, uplighting wall sconces.
Yeah. Okay. So that will need to be changed.
Right.
Okay.
The water pollution control, are they set? Because it's I just have a note that they had something at the ART.
I didn't see any issues here from the ART with respect to water pollution control here.
Fire department said it was acceptable, and it was a traffic officer that said about the fire trucks making the turns, that was a little bit
interesting.
Different.
Yes.
Yeah. And there were concerns from the engineering.
Just one.
Okay. Yeah. Right.
Just one comment.
But as long as that's taken care of.
Yes.
And I have one question, too, about the employee parking, because that was something else that was brought up that I read, that the employees be parked.
Yeah. Yeah, there are, you should know that the same number of employees that are there now will be there in this new building.
Yeah.
Okay. The shifts, this is going to be a 24-hour facility, the same as it is now. And the drive-through will be open from 11 to 5 a.m. I am, you know, obviously the site is only having 47 parking spaces. You don't have employees, you know, especially at shift change, park on your site and take up valuable space.
Oh boy, no.
The reason why you have a regional shopping center and parking all around, okay, you have mutual agreements that would allow certainly parking to occur, either, you know, customer parking or employee parking. And so what I'm recommending is that they at least strongly encourage their employees to park, you know, on the abutting property.
That upper part for generally is not much used.
No, it's not.
And, so, they have there's a lease agreement, and they have cross access and parking rights,
right.
And that's already in place.
Plenty of room for them to park.
And then there is in the packet, you know, that was handed in today. I know it was just handed in today because we were responding to the comments. That does have TT-1, which does show the fire truck making it all the way around the building.
Okay.
Oh, not in this packet, but you have it.
Well, I have to. Again, I'm part-time and I have to watch my hours, so I wasn't here this afternoon.
I know.
So it was handed to me tonight.
Let's see. The operating hours should be on the conditions. We don't have a set of conditions tonight.
Well, actually, you do.
we do? All right.
Just in case, I put some together.
I didn't see it.
No, I mean it.
That's what I thought.
Oh, you have them.
John has them. He's going to pass them out.
Okay.
Well, then, if you'll give us a few minutes to. Fast reading, darling. We've got to give the people that can read fast.
And what about them? They should get this.
Yes,
okay.
I think I have enough.
It was actually listed in that December 17th memo from the company, the hours.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
So, Water Pollution had a question about the grease trap that was also answered.
Yeah, that's.
Okay.
Yeah, they're replacing it, that's true.
Those
yeah, that's what I was working on.
Just out of curiosity, what does the staff do for the 16 weeks or whatever it's out of business?
No, they don't. So what they actually do, you know, and I can't speak to this specifically because it deals with our local franchisee, but, you know, this franchisee in particular owns several stores. So what he will do is he will actually absorb those employees into his other restaurants so that they don't have to not work.
Not a requirement question. I was just
curious. Correct.
Now, I have a couple little questions because I asked about the crosswalk be put in there and paved. We would just add that into this?
Yep.
Okay. And the downlighting, you already answered that?
It's not going to be up. It's all going to be down.
Okay.
Yeah, it should be in there.
They'll recommend it as a condition.
Okay, so conditions. Let's start.
And that's under 14. Some conditions and findings on number one, on page one and two.
Can I ask a question about 14E, or am I speaking out of turn?
No, go ahead.
It says the height of the flush concrete curb shall be increased to 8 inches. Well, flush curb is
flush.
So is it 6-inch reveal instead of 8-inch? Is it 8-inch reveal instead of 6-inch reveal? Or is it 8 inches wide instead of?
I wish I could answer that,
I mean,
because
either way,
I did
we'll
not
whatever,
see Mr. Kabibbo either.
He wants. Yeah, I mean, as soon as we get in touch with him,
we'll change the wording on that. Where is that? What are you referring to?
The height of the flush concrete curb shall be 8 inches.
14E.
I mean, you could add, like, as required by the town engineer or whatever.
Yes.
Sure, you can say that.
Do whatever he wants us to do.
The height of the concrete curb shall be in accordance with the town engineer.
Yeah, that's why we were trying to call him to find out what.
Well, that's fine. That's what we'll just put in there and leave it there. I don't see the time in here, and it should be in. So, any change in time, they got to come back.
I'm
24. It's open 24 hours, right? Wasn't it?
Yes.
Well, it is, but the windows. The are windows. Right. Well, you can leave them that way if you want. If you don't want to, that's a problem. Yeah. Okay.
Charlie, they had published a memo dated December 17th. It says the lobby and drive-through operating hours will be 5 a.m. to 12 p.m. Right. Sunday through Wednesday. The restaurant will operate 24 hours Thursday through Saturday, with the lobby closing at 11 p.m. and only the drive-through operating from 11 to 5 a.m.
So we would put that in
there. I don't
know
if that's in there or not, but it was in this correspondence.
I know, but it's in the correspondence, but again, enforcement doesn't look at the correspondence.
But if he maintains the operator maintains his existing hours that he has today.
He does.
Who put those hours in there?
They did.
They did.
It was in there. I saw it somewhere.
December 17th.
Well, that's why, but it should be referred to or
in the conditions.
So the document, Mr. Chairman, the document that you have in front of you is their narrative?
Yes.
Okay. You can make reference to that narrative. Ours shall be as referenced in the narrative dated, was it December
17th?
Okay. Fine. And that could be...
Are you Michelle?
An F?
You wrote it?
What?
Are you Michelle?
Yes.
Yeah, you wrote it.
Yeah, I know. But I don't remember December 17th, all those little details.
So that would be item F.
Well, that's actually for modification of plans.
Okay. Well,
it should be somewhere else.
13, and then renumber?
I think that'd be fine.
After 12, up above, not before the conditions which must be met prior. Would be a 13.
All right, hours.
And refer to the letter.
And the crosswalk.
And the
crosswalk paving.
Crosswalk.
Striping.
I guess we got everything.
So where is the crosswalk striping gonna go? Into the parking lot there.
It's on the east side of the building, the entrance exit on the east side of the building towards the shopping, the plaza
right.
parking.
Mm-hmm.
Right in front of the third window of the drive-through side.
Okay. So that would be...
That would be under 14.
Okay.
F. And you're saying that a crosswalk would be, again, where? Could you describe that so I can get...
On the east side... Of the building,
in between the last two windows.
If you're looking at SP-1, John, and you're looking on the east entrance exit going toward the plaza. You see where it says "Thank you" on the pavement?
I don't have those plans right in front of me right now. What I'm trying to do is just come up with a motion that would describe where it is.
It would be it's a crosswalk from the east side entrance exit.
Please put the picture on the screen on the it.
Sure.
There. No.
Not you, them.
Okay, so it's going from the east side entrance to.
Could you do the elevation?
Sure. Towards the Brookshot, across the driveway, towards the Brookside Plaza.
Yeah.
Right here. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, you got the elevation in front of you then. You got.
The Brookside Plaza.
Correct.
Okay.
Across, it's going to be striped across the 30-foot wide driveway.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, I have that.
And it's just a matter of safety. Is there going to be anything on the inside door if people come out that door? Something to pay attention to cars crossing?
There's a railing, actually. You can't walk right out into... into the traffic because there is a railing. You have to walk out and then get to the crosswalk
people
to go.
People need reminding several times, but okay. See the need of it, they'll do it.
I wish we could make everything idiot-proof. I mean, if you have a suggestion.
I don't know. That's why I set a sign on the inside door.
You know, people looking at their phones and...
Crossing traffic.
Handicapped
entries
too, right?
No, it's not.
That's not on the north side.
No, the accessible entrance, is on the north side.
That's just a regular... regular walk.
Correct.
Well, you do have them coming around to get in line, and sometimes they want to be first, and they race each other around the door.
The only way to make it idiot-proof is have somebody hold their hand when you're
exactly.
Okay. We can't require that.
Okay.
Anything else?
No. No. I just noticed the interior really is basically the same as the interior of this one. Location of service and everything else.
It's a lot nicer inside. And if you go over to the Manchester one inside, it's really a nice updated. If you're in that area on Spencer Street, you should go in it.
It's one in Hartford too, down near the airport.
Yeah, Brainerd Road. The one in Manchester is even more.
Do you have movable chairs? Because a lot of seniors, at this one in particular, are there in the morning, and they all like to get together. I don't know if they're all anchored chairs.
It's interior.
No, I'm just wondering. It's just
so it varies. There's several options that you can choose from. Sometimes they do have stools that are movable and things like that, but it's up to our local franchisee to determine.
Okay. Well, he probably knows that. I mean, because there's quite a crew that does meet that.
Last of the conditions.
Okay, sorry.
17. Sorry.
Oh, that's fine.
In the general conditions, we needed to add the word site after use site. Use, comma, site, or structure. It was just omitted. That was the...
Does that reappear again? Yeah, usually it's in two places.
Yeah, it's up top, but it's not done yet.
Okay.
So
okay.
I guess that's all I have.
It's got to be the last.
Do you have any problem with the conditions or as amended?
No,
okay.
We don't.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
Do you want me, before you actually make the motion, do you want me to just go over those two that were just sort of dictated to me so that you feel comfortable with it first?
Yeah. Okay. Yep, that's the best to do.
So I have number 13, which will say hours of operation shall be as represented in the applicant's letter of December 17th, 2014. And then 14F would say a crosswalk shall be added. From the east, extending from the east side entrance across the driveway towards the Brookside Plaza.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Do we need the
conditions of the fire marshal?
I have the conditions.
I know, it was the engineer.
I have the height of the flush concrete curb shall be increased to 8 inches, satisfactory to the town engineer.
Okay. She did that, right?
She did fire marshal, so it's taken care of, she says.
How about the lights?
And the lights?
You have a C, deals with the lights, okay. 14C.
Got it.
And they're going to say, all lights upward. Just kidding. I just wanted to say one more time.
You want to see if everybody's paying attention.
Okay. Anything further? Is that it, John?
I think that's it.
Okay. Solely in a downward manner.
You have some findings that will, I think, clarify some of the issues that I raised.
We have one. Anybody in the audience would like to speak in favor or against this application? Anyone in the audience would like to speak in favor or against this application? It's your chance. Anyone in the audience would like to speak in favor or against this application? Hearing none, John, or Peter, all right to close, no problem. I'll close public hearing 2814.
I'd like to make a motion to waive the following sections of the site plan requirements of Section 10 of the Enfield Zoning Regulations in connection with application public hearing 2814 McDonald's. And those are listed in a draft motion that John Pagini presented with us. I don't see a date on it.
Tonight.
Let's stamp a date tonight.
Stamp a date on it.
1/22.
You have the date stamp there?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there's 6 sections.
So what date stamp are you using?
Well, it says January 22nd, 2022.
Okay.
Document that's date stamped January 22nd from John Pagini.
Second.
Motion's made and seconded concerning the waivers. Any questions? Hearing none, call the roll.
Charles Duran.
Four.
Elizabeth Ballard.
Four.
Kathleen Tarnow.
Four.
Peter Falk. Four. Lori Longi.
Four.
Nicholas Fakes.
Four.
Charles Land.
Four.
Motion passes 7-0-0.
I'd like to make a motion that we approve the application public hearing 2814 of McDonald's for the special use permit to reconstruct the existing McDonald's located at 28 Hazard Avenue. And they were listed in that same document that John Puccini presented to us. Date stamped the 22nd. There are there's 23 conditions listed, but we made some modifications, and I don't know how you renumbered them.
Well, the cause for renumbering.
Second.
Okay. maybe we'd like to read them in or just accept what he read before?
Well, read them in now, John. You want to read them in now?
You want to read all the conditions in?
Not yep. all of them, well, just no. the ones we added.
Just the ones
added.
Okay. Number 13 is a new one, and it says hours of operation shall be as represented in the application.
Your mic on?
Mike.
Is your mic on?
Apparently not. I'll start again. Apologies. Number 13, new one added, hours of operation shall be as represented in the applicant's letter of December 17, 2014. And then number 13 shall become 14, 14 shall become 15. 15.
Just add that it's renumbered.
Okay, renumbered all the way to the end. Let's see, subsection E of 15 says the height of the flush concrete curb shall be increased to 8 inches, satisfactory to the town engineer. F. A crosswalk shall be added extending from the east side entrance to across the driveway across the driveway towards the Brookside Plaza. On number 18, the word site in the second line is after the word use. So it would say use, comma, site, or the structure. Okay. And I think that covers it.
Okay. I did have one question, because I thought that you requested that the height of the flush concrete curb yes. shall be in accordance to the town engineer. And take the 8 inches out, because we weren't sure
okay.
where that applied.
Yeah. Shall be.
He wasn't sure if it was 8 or not or what yet.
Yeah,
because it's supposed to be flush. You don't want it right. 8 inches.
Okay, shall be in accordance with the requirements of the town engineer?
Yes.
Right, but it's got to stay flush.
Why didn't we do this for Dunkin' Donuts?
Because they didn't have a flat thing.
In Raffia Plaza.
Okay, the,
second.
Okay, the motion's made second. And you have no problem with all these changes. No. Right? Yeah. Okay, motion's made and seconded, and... call or roll.
Charles Duran.
Four.
Elizabeth Ballard.
Four.
Kathleen Tarnow.
Four.
Peter Falk. Four. Lori Longi.
Four.
Nicholas Fakes.
Four.
Charles Land.
Four.
7-0-0. And thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good luck.
The improvement to service there.
Time to bring some Big Macs.
Hope you get another 6-week project.
We usually keep the sampum.
I don't know. Do you want them, John, or
those?
They're
official. I'll tell you what. We'll wait until the appeal period passes, and then we'll give them back to them.
Yeah, all right. Okay. Because I know we've had several that we've saved, and they had problems with the weight on buildings. Yeah. So I think we don't need to keep.
We'll give them back.
Okay. Thank you. Old business, none. New business, none. Other business, nothing. Authorization, administrative approvals.
Nothing, Mr.
Nothing.
Nothing, Mr. Chairman.
Application to be received.
Oh, dear.
None?
Tell us none.
No, what is that?
Applications to be received.
Thank you.
Take them home and read them in bed.
She's been in before, I remember.
Bedtime reading. I have to go.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Change of use.
Sleeping pill.
Uh,
get a good night's rest. Enfield Street. Where's that? Where's 904 Enfield Street?
Right up here on Dunn.
It's in the plaza where a whole donut is.
Oh, up here?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, all right. Well, they're back really to the same old area because they came out of High Street.
Yeah, we just talked about that at Revite, actually.
Okay. Now, this has to go to Revite, doesn't it? So
it went tonight.
Oh, it is.
Yeah, right. So it'll be on the agenda. Well, it can be on the agenda for next week.
Okay. Well, it really shouldn't be too long.
No, from what I saw, it should really be an easy one.
All righty.
Well, pitch your pup before me.
What have we got, John? Do you know what we have on the next agenda? I don't want to get it loaded.
I think this is basically it, what you're seeing okay. Right now. There are no continuations from tonight.
The Gary Goodwill store. And this is Palumba Drive.
Where is that?
It's a new store, so they got room in.
Let's see. We're talking about Palumba Drive.
Right.
Yeah, that is the Big White Plaza, I believe. And what they're planning to do is
at the end. That's the one with the separate.
They're gonna go to the end because they're gonna have a drive through drop off.
Okay.
And then there's gonna be a space in between that will be filled in eventually.
Center. So for now, it'll be a freestanding.
Exactly.
Correct.
That's not my business. It's very costly. New site plan application. Medical building.
Take any chance
of being
cold.
Well, that's where public hearing, too.
Is that across from the Tarsinus Plaza?
I believe it
well,
is.
Well, I got the heat turned off so we
yes,
get done
this
faster.
Is that's directly across from the Tarsinus Plaza, where Dunkin' Donuts is.
Well, there's a medical building in there now.
Dr.
Right?
Way
Pantel.
In the back.
Oh. EHR or CHR or something like that. It's way in the back.
Correct, but this is on the other side of the road.
Yeah.
That's on the Dunkin' Donuts side.
I don't know. Okay, but it's up in there.
Sorry?
Is it Krishna or something like that?
Yeah, it's Dr. Panchal, I thought, it's building. Is it next in front for it, before that? The Krishna?
It's a field.
Yeah, this is the one. It's a vacant lot.
Oh, okay. That's what we were doing. Because right across the street, I thought that was his
No, building. It's a vacant lot.
It's a okay.
Yes.
Yeah, there's a that's two-story
Phil's.
Medical.
That's not Phil's.
Okay.
Across the street from Phil.
Yeah,
correct. It's across the street.
From Phil.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a new building.
There is a medical building there.
A little further down.
A little further down. Yeah. That's the Krishna.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. That's
center.
What we're trying
but
to do.
But that's a little
out.
Further
where?
Down.
Yeah. Okay. What do you think? Help me out. Do you think, can we handle? Are they all ready? Are they all of these ready? They've been through ART and so forth?
Well, actually, Domino's has. Let's see. Goodwill has long ago, before I came, and the last one has been through, ART once.
Well, you said once. That means they are done, or they.
Well, I think they're done. They had fairly advanced plans at the time.
I don't want to load it up too much.
Yeah.
Just pizza. For clarification, the home husbandry and the medical facilities, we're going to address that at the next regular meeting?
Well, that's on the 5th. We're talking about the 5th for all of these.
Oh, so that
why
is
why I brought it up.
Yeah,
yeah. Okay. So then I would say maybe we shouldn't do the medical then because then
okay,
we'd have too
put
much.
Put that on the next one.
So that would be SPR 1641 on the 19th.
But do you want that's an SPR? You want that as a public hearing? Because that's our
I would
call.
Think so.
Yeah, I would too.
Those okay. People over on Middle Road.
So that would be
oh,
a
no,
public.
They do.
Post developers in
their
backyard.
Yeah, they. Yeah, you're right. They do.
So on the 19th, SPR, that will be a public hearing.
Yeah. Anything really along Hazard Avenue, but especially because it backs up to Middle Road, and if it's up near the condos too, they. They usually like to know.
This is further down from the condos,
no,
across from the
no,
library.
I mean, but Tarsinus' condos are Okay. Okay. So the next two are for the next meeting, and then the next one goes on in February. Well, they're both February. Uh-huh. All right. Anything else?
Motion to adjourn.
No, wait a minute. Oh. So the planning meeting for the 12th is a parking study, solar regulations, and the service trucks.
And the beginning of the food trucks.
Yeah, but make sure we get the material beforehand.
Yeah, we will find some model regulations for you and get them to you beforehand.
But they've got to be either, I don't care if they're out of Massachusetts because we can fit them to ours too, but they at least have them the same size and population of Enfield.
Like, we just want all the town stuff. Because so we can't
be compared to Hartford or Bridgeport or any of those.
Similar size and demographics.
Yep. Okay. Anything else, ladies, gentlemen? Peter, you were here last time too. Could you please talk to him about the heat?
Oh yes, yes. I asked the custodian about it. He can't control it. It's a building and grounds issue. So I will.
But if the buildings and grounds know we have a meeting.
That's what I'm saying. I will have to pass it on to buildings and grounds.
It did?
Yeah.
Well,
it's cold now.
I didn't feel. Maybe it's because there's no heat downstairs. And I don't know. Because you end up. Well. Okay. What do you do? Did
make
I have
a motion to adjourn?
Second.
Motion's made to adjourn. All in favor?
Aye.
Good. Stand adjourned. 5. I think we froze the other ones out.
Yeah, they did. I think they got too cold.